Today we're going to talk about oxygen sensors. So you may be thinking, well, if he's talking about oxygen sensors, why is he holding the carburetor? Because you're probably taking your grocery getter or a race car and you're updating it, and you're very likely going from a carburetor to some form of a fuel injection system like our Terminator throttle body that we have here, maybe a Holley sniper system or a multi-port kit. The carburetor works off of air velocity through the venturi that basically creates the fuel signal to meter and atomize fuel to feed the engine. When you're going to fuel injection, it requires the use of multiple sensors to give feedback to the ECU for it to make its fuel calculations and to control the delivery from your fuel mapping or your fuel tables. One of those sensors is the oxygen sensor. They call it an oxygen sensor for a reason, because it senses the unburnt oxygen. I have a lot of people that think it senses unburnt fuel. That's just not the case. Otherwise, they call it an unburnt fuel sensor. Placement of the sensor is very important. Proper placement of the sensor should ideally be between 6 to 8 inches after the merge in your collector, with at least 18 to 24 inches of exhaust pipe after the sensor. And that extra length of pipe is to keep atmospheric reversion from allowing ambient outside oxygen to work its way back into the pipe to give you false readings. Holley offers a couple different ways to install the oxygen sensor. We have your conventional round weld-in style oxygen sensor bung. We also offer a clamp-on style O2 bung that comes with a cast stainless steel mounting bung. And these are available for some different common diameter pipes that have specific radiuses. They include high-quality T-bolt style clamps and a high-temperature gasket that gives you a nice method of installing that O2 sensor in a secure way without the need of a welder. Now, the reason we offer this is because a lot of times you may not have the ability to weld or have immediate access to a welder, so you can clamp it on, and this works temporary, even permanent. If you want it for a temporary installation, you could put this on, get the vehicle running, then take it to your muffler shop, and they can take this same bung and they can weld it or braze it onto your pipe for you. A couple of things that you want to avoid, and we see this quite often, is poor quality welds that introduce oxygen into the stream. In this case, we have a burn through on the welded bung. It's also in the wrong location. In this installation, it is basically reading off of one primary tube instead of getting an average of four cylinders, which would be created by this distance from the merge. Some other things you don't want to have in your exhaust system that wouldn't have been bothered when you're dealing with the carburetor, wouldn't cause any issues, is the classic hose clamp and pop can plug over a hole. Poorly fitting flanges, poor welds, oxygen sensor installations with coat hanger, hose clamps, JB weld, a lot of RTV on the flanges, holding your exhaust together with vice grips, hose clamps, pipe clamps. We've seen all different things that are going on. You want to be conscientious about where you route your wiring. You want to avoid high temperature, high heat sources that could burn up the wiring. You also want to avoid anything that it could be pinched on or moving that can fray it. Once again, make sure that you don't mount the oxygen sensor at the end of the exhaust pipe. And please don't do what we see here and just drill a hole in the exhaust and stick the O2 sensor in it. That's just not going to support what you need. Anything that introduces a false signal to the O2 sensor, any type of air leaks, as small as a pinhole in the wrong place in the exhaust system, can be detrimental to overall engine operation, especially at idle and part throttle. When you install the O2 sensor, if you're using a Holley EFI system, depending on the type of system, you have some options on the O2 sensors. If the oxygen sensor that you get with your system, say for a Terminator, HP, or a Dominator system, has this little bag with a warning on it, you want to read that. If you don't program the system for the proper sensor before you plug this in, you're going to damage the sensor, and you can really damage it in under a minute. There's some things that cause premature sensor failures or damage to the sensors, and the common ones are going to be excessive fuel, oil control issues, or additives or chemicals, right down to sealants that may have been used during the assembly of the engine that just are not compatible with the oxygen sensor. If you're running a carburetor and you have oil control problems, the car smokes when you start it in the morning, it's blowing some blue smoke, sitting in idle and normal operation, you need to really correct that. That excessive oil control issues is going to foul the sensor out, and it's going to cause it to fail. Excessive fuel is one of the quickest ways to kill an oxygen sensor. So what do you think is going to happen if you have a leak in the exhaust that's telling the ECU that it's running lean? The ECU is going to react accordingly by adding more fuel. The problem is it really doesn't need more fuel, and you're going to wash that sensor down with fuel and it's going to cause it to fail. The telltale sign of a damaged O2 sensor that's usually caused by fouling by some sort of chemical, excessive fuel, or oil is that the O2 sensor all of a sudden will just read dead lean. And it's because it basically plugs it up and it can't analyze exhaust gases. So if all of a sudden a vehicle starts running extremely rich and you look at your O2 sensor readings and it's reading in the 30 to 35 to 1 range, chances are that you fouled this sensor. If that happens, you really need to figure out what caused it to begin with. Otherwise, you're going to keep putting O2 sensors in it and wondering why they keep failing. It's important to avoid what I call trash in, trash out. Make sure that you have a clean installation with a solid platform. Make sure that you're not dealing with high temperature issues with wiring, pinched wires, improper installations that can cause any type of oxygen to get in the system. Cylinder misfires will also do the same thing, because you're not burning all of the oxygen. So if you have an engine that has an ignition problem, it is going to throw everything off the rails. You want to also be conscious about excessive fuel, because a lot of people don't realize an engine can actually be so rich that it reads lean. Now, as you guys are scratching your head and trying to figure out what I'm talking about, as we mentioned, this thing reads unburned oxygen. So if your fuel mixture is excessively rich, it's really not going to burn properly. You're going to have incomplete combustion, which this is going to pick up that unburned oxygen. It in turn is going to tell your ECU, your engine management system, to add more fuel. Well, what do you think is going to happen? You add more fuel, it's even richer. It's going to burn less of the oxygen. It's going to make it read leaner, and it's going to react accordingly. Take your time during your installation. Look things over. Anything that could possibly allow any oxygen into the system as small as a pinhole in the exhaust, anywhere from the combustion process to 18 to 24 inches after the O2 sensor, is going to cause you some problems. It may not be a major issue, or it might be. Make sure that your installation is tight, your engine platform is solid. If you have ignition problems, vacuum leaks, valve train problems, bad fuel, you need to correct those things before you convert over to fuel injection, and it's just going to make things go a lot smoother and simplify troubleshooting if you do run into a problem in the future, if you correct that problem before you ever get started. For more helpful Holley tech tips and videos, go to holley.com.